Yes, my name is Miina Nurmi, and like we just heard, the topic of my speech hasn't been revealed yet, but you will get a chance to guess what I'm going to talk about. I will do some mimes, and when you think you got a clue, just feel free to shout out loud. Okay, ready?
Morning sickness.
Very good. It's nausea and vomiting of pregnancy. It's also called MVP, or like we heard, morning sickness is the layman term for that. But since this is a scientific presentation, I think I also should reveal to you the scientific Latin name of the extreme form of MVP. That is hyperemesis gravidarum. It's just, you know, extreme vomiting during pregnancy, but it's very fancy in Latin. But why should anybody study something like this? I mean, it's such a normal part of pregnancy, isn't it? You know, morning sickness is a real cliche. That's how you know in movies that the leading lady is pregnant. She runs somewhere, comes back, she's fine, she's completely fine all the way until the end of the movie. And usually it's a happy end too, so a normal happy thing. Why pay so much attention to it? Well, unfortunately, for some women, it's not so simple, because sometimes it can be so overwhelming. You know, you can't eat, can't breathe, can't really think clearly, and in some cases it just goes on and on. For weeks, for months, sometimes all the way till the end of the pregnancy, which unfortunately has led some women to decide to terminate a pregnancy that they initially wanted. Now that's awful. Something should be done. I mean, we should know something about this. Somebody should try to find out what causes it. How could we help these women? I mean, there must be something one could do. We must try to find it out. And luckily, it has been studied. There are actually many, many hundreds, thousands of studies about MVP, about the extreme form hyperemesis. There have been guidelines that have been published for hospital treatment, or guidelines for managing mild forms of MVP at home. And we have found out many factors that are associated with the causes of MVP. I mean, hormones usually, of course, they play a huge role because, well, during pregnancy, there are many hormonal changes ongoing in the woman's body. But since not all women get MVP, and even fewer, about 1% among all pregnancies get hyperemesis gravidarum, then there must be some individual factors that play a huge role in the pathogenesis. And even though we know so much about it, the real problem is that this information may not be used efficiently. It may not penetrate all the way to the women who would need that information. Has anybody among the audience experienced MVP if you've been pregnant? No, you've been lucky. Well, I asked about 200 pregnant women about their experiences of MVP, and out of the 200, maybe 150 had experienced MVP, and out of these women, 45 had asked for help at their maternity healthcare center. So they have asked healthcare professionals for aid and for advice of how to treat it. And out of these 45 women, 21 said that they would have needed more advice. They didn't get enough help to cope in their everyday life. And I had a bit of the same experience. I mean, you get all sorts of tips, like snacking, for example. Snacking on salmiakki helped me a lot. I'm not pregnant at the moment, so feel free to pass this along. You may do the snacking this time. But yeah, to do something about this, we have set us some goals in our study. First, to raise awareness. The more you know about something, the better you can do something about it. This will hopefully lead to better treatment, and hopefully it will reduce suffering. These are all fancy, idealistic goals. How are we going to reach them? Well, here are some of the means. Of course, we're going to use the existing research. Like we saw, there are many, many publications, excellent publications. We just have to use that information and spread it as much as we can. And since we are at the university, of course, one of the main goals is to find some new answers. And this is at the core of my study. It's called the Please Stop study. Partly, we are using existing healthcare registers. We have a data set of more than 5,000 women who have been hospitalized for MVP, so from the severe end of the spectrum. And we are also recruiting some of patients of our own at the university hospital. We are aiming at getting about 100 hyperemesis patients. And we are also recruiting healthy, happy, normal, expecting mothers at the healthcare centers. So among those women, there will be some who have suffered from MVP and some who are completely fine through their pregnancy. And with all this information, we are also going to train the healthcare professionals in the Turku region. We've already started. We are spreading some of the information that we've got from the existing research. Because, well, you all know how wonderful it is to do research. You've got your data set. You can go through it. You can find so many interesting things. But if you just hide behind it, keep it all to yourself, enjoy it all by yourself, it's completely useless. Unless you can communicate your results and your findings to everybody who needs those results in their life. So, my message to all of those who maybe sometime want to get pregnant but are now wondering whether it's worthwhile since there might be these kinds of complications waiting, don't despair. Help is coming. We are studying as much as we can. Thank you.